Now for our feature presentation.
YouTube, what's going on, man? It's your boy Double R. You're tuned into Ron Real TV. I want to give a huge shout out to everybody that's tuning in right now and checking out what the kid has going on. I really appreciate it. So go ahead and hit that like button on your way in, man. Comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell. That way you're notified anytime I'm dropping content. And like the intro suggested, man, this will be a lifestyle channel, man. It'll be vlogs, cigar reviews, fitness with like weightlifting, fashion, whatever it may be, man. I'm gonna make sure you guys are tuned in and be able to kind of do like a day in the life kind of deal, man. See what I got going on. Today, actually, I'm gonna head over to the cigar spot here in a second. Go have me a little morning cigar, man, and take you guys with me. Again, I want to say a huge, huge shout out again for everybody that's taking the time out of your day to watch me, man. Much love. So I'm heading to the cigar spot now, man. It's just a normal lounge that we got 24/7 access to. We don't sell cigars or tobacco in there, but you know, you can come in there at any given time. People are in there sometimes. Sometimes people ain't in there. We'll sit around and just watch TV. You know, we got quite a few TVs in there. Smoke cigars. We got a full bar in there too. It's just kind of one of those things, man. Thing to have is like a vice away from reality sometimes, but yeah, it's cool, man. It's a pretty nice size, and like I said, it's ours, man. And, you know, it's cool. So I just got to the lounge, man. There's nobody here right now, which, you know, kind of before 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon, there's not that many people here. I'm an early bird kind of guy because, you know, I work 24-hour shifts. So a lot of times I'll come by right when I get off work at 7 in the morning, or I'll go to the gym and work out. So around, you know, 10:30, 11 o'clock in the morning, I'll be up here too. So This is pretty common to not have anybody here yet. So, yeah, man. But this is the spot that we hang out in. And, you know. So, today I'll be smoking a Espinosa Habano. Espinosa makes pretty good cigars. I like a lot of that stuff. They also do the 601 line, which I'm a fan of, too. So, we will light this one today and you know, tell you what I think about it. Today we're gonna just do a normal guillotine cut. It's pretty common. Pretty good draw. I'm gonna go old school today, man, and light it with a match. That's one thing about me, man. I prefer smaller ring gauge cigars, so like Lanceros, Coronas, Robustos, and Toros are probably the sizes that I prefer. Some guys don't like small cigars, but I think they taste better and they're stronger. Generally, I like stronger cigars. So I like more medium to full body cigars and medium to full strength. I do dabble with Connecticuts now. Like, I finally got back into those. When I first started, I started on Maduros and
high, like strong, like, you know, stronger cigars. And I think, you know, if I would tell people now, like if you're just getting into cigars, I would say start off with like, you know, flavored cigars or like a Connecticut Leaf or Sun Grown, things that are a little lighter. I don't know if I would recommend jumping straight off into like, you know, Oscuros or Maduros or like Mexican scented, you know, like darker cigars and stuff like that, man. Like, I feel like it kind of ruined the experience for me for a while because I got so used to smoking those cigars and kind of just getting a nicotine buzz. So when I had the Connecticuts or the lighter cigars, I didn't really appreciate them like I do now. So just kind of a heads up, man. If you, like I said, if you're just getting into it, don't be afraid to smoke like Connecticuts or lighter cigars. I think that's actually the preferred way. So. Here, man, like I said, it's not really a rush to do it. Just toast the foot up, you know. Sometimes it might take more than one match, but yeah, we'll go ahead and use one more. We're pretty good, but I'm gonna go ahead and just get one more going. I started smoking cigars in 2015, so 4 years now, man, and like I said, I started out with stronger cigars. I wish I would have probably started out with lighter cigars. First cigar that was given to me was, like I said, back in 2015, it was a Macanudo Maduro, which at the time I didn't know a Maduro was a shade of leaf or a style of leaf. I thought Maduro was just like a name brand, so. You know, I had that cigar and was obviously, I was drinking with that too. So I liked the way that it made me feel, you know, so I was a fan of it. And just kept on going from there, man. I've been smoking ever since, so. Yeah, this one's pretty good. Like I said, I smoke Espinosas a lot. I smoke Espinosas, I smoked a lot of Tatuaje, I smoke Crown Heads, LFD, Padron, Roma Craft, Eroa or CLE, CAOs, Drew Estate. I used to smoke a lot of Caldwell cigars, I don't really much anymore. A lot of the newer blends I've had, I'm not really a huge fan of them. I also like Fuente cigars, My Father's are some good cigars too. I'm pretty much all over the board now as far as like brands, strength, things like that. So I feel like now I have a greater appreciation for cigars than, you know, back in 2015 where, I mean, I think my sole purpose of smoking cigars was to get the effect of the nicotine and I wasn't really appreciating flavor or just the whole essence of or being a cigar smoker. So I feel like there's a difference between people that smoke cigarettes and cigars. I feel like people that smoke cigarettes are addicted to them, where I feel like people that smoke cigars, it's more of a lifestyle thing, you know. There are days I don't smoke at all. There are days I only smoke one cigar. There are days that I may smoke four cigars. It just kind of depends on what I have going on, what's going on around me. It just really depends, so, you know. Yeah, man, this is just a really good cigar. I'm cool right now. Normally, too, I always carry a piece of chocolate with me. If you get caught up in eating certain foods like Italian, Chinese, or you eating like fruity candy, stuff like that, sometimes if you haven't gave yourself a chance to recover from eating that stuff, if you go smoke a cigar right behind it, it can affect the taste of cigars. There have been many cigars that I actually enjoyed, and you know, once I ate some food and came back and smoked a cigar that I've had previously that I liked, it tasted a lot different, sometimes not for the better. So you just have to be careful with that. Some people drink sparkling water. I like regular water, or I'll settle for like a dark piece of chocolate. So some of these cigars I've smoked for a long time, and you'd be surprised, I actually haven't really did a lot of research on them. You know, I just, a lot of times I go in the cigar lounge and just, you know, if especially if it's a brand that I'm familiar with and I like their products, I don't have to necessarily know everything about that particular cigar. I'll just pick it up and go from there. So this cigar here so far, definitely will put it on like a medium body as far as the flavor profile. It's not super intense, but it's there. Everything is kind of, you know, there's some nuttiness to it, but the flavors to me aren't really, you know, they're not really where you could just pick single ones out. It's more like things are merged together right now. I don't detect any strength, like, you know, but flavors are pretty good, so we'll just keep going, we'll keep smoking. About 15 minutes in now. It's burning pretty good. Not terrible. I've seen better, but not terrible. Still not really any strength. Definitely like the earth tones, like I was mentioning before, like it's just kind of earthy. It has that you'll know when you taste it. If you never smoked cigars and you smoke them, it's kind of acquired. Like most people that equate the earthiness, they're like, I don't know if I like, it's just kind of just, you know. There is a nice like cedar taste to it. It's got some cedar and some black pepper too on it. It's not too intense. The retrohale is a little higher, but all in all, like I said, definitely still a medium body, it's a medium flavored cigar. And I'd say medium strength, like nothing to really worry about. About 30 minutes in now, we're definitely in the second third, like I said. Look at that burn line. Look at that ash. Can't beat it. Have not touched it up once. Still medium body. Still medium strength. Another thing I want to mention too, not to anybody that's been smoking before. I mean, maybe they know, maybe they don't, but definitely to the newer people that are just getting into cigars or thinking about it. When you're smoking cigars, man, don't get caught up in rushing so much. To me, that's why I said there's a difference between the cigarette smokers and cigar smokers, where I feel like this is a lifestyle kind of thing. So for me, when I equate the lifestyle, that's why I was mentioning earlier, I'm kind of a slower smoker, but I feel like to me, your flavors are better when you're slower because you're keeping the core cool. The object of the game is to keep the cigar as cool as possible. When the cigar starts getting hot, some blends burn fast and they burn hot, so there's nothing you can do about that. But a lot of times, newer people, they smoke so fast and you char the tobacco and then your flavors will get all jacked up and they start getting bitter and tart and stuff, so, and that throws everything off. So you'll notice, like, a lot of times with me, like, some people will say one time a minute. I don't even count. Like, I just, you know, I feel like over the years, I just built a natural progression to know when to take it, and it's just almost a subconscious effort. Just, it just happens. So, like I said, sometimes a normal cigar that may take somebody an hour, it may take me an hour and 15. Or, you know, if there's a Corona that some people burn in 30 to 45, it may take me right under an hour. It just depends, you know, but I'm definitely on the slower end of smoking. Like I said, I feel like the benefits outweigh the negative things when you're smoking slower. And on top of that, you're relaxing, man. You know, it's almost like getting a massage. Nobody wants to get a massage done in 10 or 15 minutes. If you want one done properly, it takes time. That 15-minute massage may be okay, but that 30-minute or that hour massage probably will be better unless the person doesn't know what they're doing. So just keep that in mind, too. Like I said, still smoking away. Go ahead and ash this thing, man. Which it fell off pretty easy. Nothing worse than, man, holding the ash too long and you trying to smoke it and it falls and gets all over your clothes, man. Nobody likes it. If you've been smoking for a long time or you've been smoking for you know, even a couple months, it's probably gonna happen to you. It's happened to us all. We all get caught up in holding our ass a little bit too long, but hey, it happens. About 45 minutes in now, closing in on the end of the second third. The sweetness has went away, and the flavors kind of the first third are back in the forefront, like the cedar, the earth. Black pepper still there. It's not overbearing. I would say it's probably around, if I had to give it a number, probably a 6 out of 10. I wouldn't say this is a super complex cigar, but it's complex enough to keep you interested. Some cigars you'll have and it's just the same way. There's no changes at all, which sometimes isn't a bad thing. My favorite cigars are made by Padron, the 1964 line, particularly the 50-year cigar is my favorite cigar of all time. And I don't feel like that's a very complex cigar, but the flavors are so full and so flavorful that they're so good it doesn't matter that nothing's changing. This, on the other hand, isn't full body. So when you have medium to full body cigars, the complexity, you usually reward that. You want the changes and shifts to keep you interested. The construction and the draw on this thing have been great. From start to finish, it was not overly loose, it wasn't overly tight like this. The draw on this cigar is perfect, about what I like cigars to be. This has been really good, like, to me, and at the price point, I can't remember what this was, I have to look it up and tell you. This is a great daily smoker. Like, you know, if you're looking through your humidor or your travel humidor or whatever, and you don't really want to put a lot of thought into it, but you want a good cigar, like this covers that. Coming to the end of the road on this one, it's not getting hot, which for me, I usually end cigars when they get hot or the flavors start kind of die down. So, like I said, it's not hot, but the flavors are kind of, you can tell that the back of the cigars are kind of, only difference is, again, the sweetness faded back out, so there the sweetness is gone again. I would say the strength picked up a little. It's on the higher side of medium. I still wouldn't even put this at a medium to full. Like, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll be seeing you guys on the next one.